guys, and welcome to a new lecture about trend lines. Now, I want to teach you guys something about trend lines where we should always take this type of chances. We take a look at this trend line and it looks like a very beautiful trend line, isn't it? A lot of people are not trend line traders, but you should also take into consideration these trend lines because traders are respecting them, as you can clearly see right here in this example. So this trend line resistance is drawn on a 4-hour chart here for Bitcoin. So let's go over 5-minute time frame and let's draw the support trend line. And I'm going to select my trend line tool from over here and I will draw it like this on the 5-minute time frame. So how does it look? Pretty crappy, right? If we change the time frame to 30 minutes, looks decent. If I go to a 3-hour time frame, it looks great. So if you draw it on different time frames, it can look very, very different, right? So what we want to consider about these regions is that they are bear traps, okay? You guys need to take into account that there are many ways to draw it. Now, if you actually draw this from week to week, this is how it would look, right? So the second one, which I'm going to make it red, is from week to week, and the white one is from body to body on a higher time frame. So now you actually have a zone right here that you would consider it a bear trap, okay? So now what is a bear trap? A bear trap is basically when the price looks like it's about to fall, but instead it reaches a region where it reverses very quickly. It breaks past a basic support point, but instead of breaking out of there with a lot of conviction, you actually get being trapped above the support or below the resistance, where you are believing that the price is going to continue in that direction, but it actually suddenly reverses. This happens sometimes by coincidence, and a lot of times actually happen because of pure manipulation in the market as well. So manipulation for some people is just manipulation, and for me, manipulation is actually strategies to steal each other's money, okay? So anyways, when you think of people with a lot of money, they want to trap you, so you have to realize that trend lines can actually be drawn differently, and that's the whole goal of this exercise in this lecture. So on 5-minute chart, this white trend line looks crappy. And if I go to, let's say, 1-hour chart, we see a very, very different concept, right? So if you are a trendline trader, you should take chances when it comes to reaching the resistance trendline to enter a short position, which means to sell. And when it comes to reaching a support trendline to enter a long position, which means to buy. And when you buy at the support trendline, always target the resistance trendline. And if you sell on the resistance trend line, always target the support trend line or wherever you are comfortable with your percentage gains, right? So that is basically it for a quick trend line lecture in which I hope that you understand very well how this technical tool works and that it was helpful for you. So thank you for watching and I will see you in the next lecture.